Hello and welcome to the channel and welcome to this match play game of Scorched Earth between the Astra Militarum and the Tyranids. We're doing Scorched Earth, and the one with Scorched Earth is you can get 5 on the primary or 10 on the primary if you've got 1 or 2 objectives, only up to 10, so if you've got 3 objectives to make a difference. But in your turn you can choose to do an action and you can start scorching an objective or cleansing it or eating the biomass on it or whatever, and then at the start of your next turn it's then gone. So if someone starts doing it, you can kill them off of it and stop them from doing it, kind of thing. So it's not the easiest thing to do in the world, but you can do it, and then you get extra points at the end of the game for all the objectives that you've scorched. But obviously if you've scorched an objective, then you can't score it the next turn. So the timing is key. If you're all over the objectives, you probably don't want to go scorching them for a while. there's extra points for doing that. We're doing minefields today because the Catachans have decided to lay some mines down. Because, you know, we've been here before and it looks as though we lost the previous battles, but we've put some mines down and we're back for the second wave. That means any advanced rolls of a 6, you take a mortal wound. So that could be interesting. And I've done Dawn of War deployment because, well, two reasons. One, it's really simple. And two, there's a road going down the middle of the battle map. So kind of makes sense. So that's the mission and things. For terrain, there's ruins scattered about. They're, of course, obscuring, so you can't shoot through them. But if you're wholly within, you can shoot out. And, of course, you can shoot into them. I'm also treating the Baneblade and the other tank as obscuring because they're big and they got smoke coming out of them. You can't shoot over them or through them, and if you're behind them, you like slightly obscured, you can get the benefit of cover from them as well. Why not? The crates will also give you the benefit of cover if you're behind them, as will the woods and bushes in the corners, and there's lots of barricades around to give you cover as well. So there is lots of cover all over the place, even though it doesn't look like it, but there we go. there's one objective right in the middle there by the crates and the barrels. One either side in no man's land, and obviously one in the centre of each deployment zone. There's also craters, I forgot to mention, which also give you cover. So there's plenty of cover everywhere. And you can't scorch your home objective, but you can score the enemy's home objective if you really wanted to, as well as the ones in no man's land. Before we see the armies and the guests of today, smash the like button, hit subscribe, there'll be a battle report or something every single week. Hopefully. And if you want to support me further, you can become a YouTube channel member to get early access, other perks, Discord, and there's loads of links below for buying things at a discount, which helps support me as well. Without further ado, it's been a while, but he's back. It's Dan, or Hello. Dawn's Apothecary on Instagram. I'll put a link below for that, because you paint lovely miniatures and you put them on Instagram, and people might want to look at bugs that look nicer than mine. So you're back. And we're doing just 1750 points today, because you haven't quite got 2,000 points of bugs painted, you said.
Not in a way that I can easily field. So this kind of sits nicely in a kind of comfortable place. So.
Yeah, okay. Do you want to go through your list
first? So we are running an invasion fleet, and the Broodlord at the front is going to be my warlord with his 5 Gene Stealer friends.
Just the 5?
Just 5.
Have you not got another 5 painted?
They're in a box.
Oh, okay.
Many, many other little gribblies.
You want 30 Gene Stealers and 3 Broodlords. okay, so you've got Broodlord with Gene Stealers.
We have some objective sort of grabbing Ripper Swarms. They are single units, or units of 1.
So three single units of Ripper Swarms, because they can deep stroke and help they with secondaries and things. Yep. Yes, don't leave home without 3 Ripper Swarms if you're a Tyranid player.
Yep. We have a Lictor who can Rapid Ingress for no CP at some point if he chooses to.
Yeah, he's also a lone operative as well, isn't he? Yeah. So that's nice.
He's helpful. 2 units of 6 Von Ryan's Leapers, which obviously put out lots of attacks. They're fairly quick. And they have fight first, which is going to be potentially helpful against...
It will be very helpful today, because I've brought combat guard, and you've got lots of blendy infantry units.
But they're not very tough, so you could always just kill them before they get to you.
What, with las guns? Yeah. I mean, I'll give it a go.
We've got a Tyranid Prime attached to a unit of 10 gargoyles.
And we can attach to gargoyles, I didn't know
that. You can drop them with the gargoyles and use them... Sustained hits on those really overwhelming
flesh
borers.
Yeah. Cool. Okay.
And then we have 2 Maliceptors.
Yes.
1 Terran Effects with a Rupture Cannon. We have a Norn Emissary. And then we have a Winged Hive Tyrant who is perfectly adapted, so he can reroll a a hit, a wound, or a damage each.
And he's got the heavy venom cannon, and he's got an ability where you can use a battle tank stratagem for free within 12 inches of him or something.
I will find out with you.
Yeah, it's quite good because you're running the invasion fleet, which has, is it Adrenal Surge, the 2 CP battle tactic where you can get
crits on fives.
Yeah, so basically you can just do that for free with him rather than spending 2 CP or any unit within 12 inches of him.
Lovely.
It's very nice. Oh, and if you've got 2 CP, you can do it on one unit and then do it on another unit within 12 inches of him for free. It's very nice. Mm-hmm. So he's quite cool. And then for those who don't know, Tyranids, you get Synapse. So anything in Synapse range, you roll 3d6 for battle shot. But no one really cares about Battleshock anyway. what's the other thing? You've got Shadow of the War. So once per game, you can Battleshock all my things. But as just mentioned, Battleshock's pretty useless. Although my leadership isn't the best. I am Guard. So
there's
might...
a chance it might do something for once.
Yes. Yes, because if you're playing Marines and things, it never really does anything. At least I've found it never really does anything anyway. Even when I have the Neuro Tyrant, which like minuses one from their test or whatever, it still doesn't do anything. but yeah. And then the invasion fleet is the detachment where at the start of the game you can pick lethal hits or sustained hits. So sustained hits against infantry or lethal against vehicles,
that's
isn't
cool,
it? I do have some vehicles, but I've got lots of infantry. But that's a decision you're going to have to make. But you shouldn't have a problem dealing with the infantry anyway, really, I don't think. Because they're just guardsmen. Is that everything for your list?
That's everything, yeah.
Cool, okay, let's talk about the guard. So, 1750 points of guard today. What do guard do? We have orders. So, in the command phase, I can order things with officers to improve weapon skill, blizzard skill, movement, objective control. Basically, pretty much any stat I like, I can improve it by one, which is nice when your stats normally are pretty rubbish. so, orders are very useful. And then we get lethal hits with ranged attacks on a turn we remain stationary. So, it's only in my turn, because I can't remain stationary in your turn, because I can't move in your turn. So it can't do it for Overwatch or anything, and then it's only if I remain stationary. So, yeah, I mean, movement wins games, and that's all I'm going to say about that. it's only good for artillery. So I'm making a fun combat guard list today, because why not? I mean, I think the Ron Leapers might be a reason why not, but fine, we'll get to them, we'll deal with them somehow. so what have I got? I've got Lord Solar, not Lord Solar, today as my Warlord. He's a CP farm. I can redeploy after deployment, and he kicks out free orders and things. He's really cool. He will be joining a 20-man infantry squad, which have a couple of plasmas in there, a couple of bolt guns, a couple of oxcasters, a load of flashlights. And also joining that infantry squad, it's going to be a command squad. And the command's got a Power Fist bolt gun. I've got a plasma gun in there. I've got a... Master Vox Medic and a banner. So the banner gives all the models in the unit an extra OC. So the guardsmen will then be free OC, which is amazing, but they're only guardsmen. and then I've also got an Ogryn bodyguard in there as well, because the unit wasn't quite big enough. I thought I'd put a big guy in with them as well. So a bit of punch there, and just plenty of bodies to literally chew through, I guess, for Tyranids. So that's the first blob. I'll move on to the second blob, which will be being led by Colonel Strachan, who's an absolute G in combat. He's got anti-monster 4-up in combat, which is nice against Tyranids. And on the charge, he can reroll all hits and all wounds. It's very nice. And he gives the entire unit lethal hits. So he's joining 20 Catachans, which get extra strength and AP on the charge. So basically, they just make Strachan even better. And I've got 3 flamers in that blob, because I haven't got 4 models with flamers. I know it's terrible. But that's that. And then also joining that blob is another command squad with a Power Fist on the commander, plasma pistol, another heavy flamer, plasma gun, medic, master vox. So another big blob. And it wasn't quite big enough, so I threw a Not Dead Og as well, who is just as killy as Strachan, to be honest. He's pretty much a boss, and he can also headbutt things and do mortal wounds. So yeah, he's good. He's very good. Hopefully, maybe we'll find out. So 2 big blobs, and then I've got a small blob. I've got just 10 Catachans with Sergeant Harker, so that unit can scout, because the entire unit has scout, whereas this whole unit doesn't have all scout. And because Sergeant Harker's leading them, if you shoot them from 12 inches away, they will be -1 to hit. Because Catachans only know how to hide behind bushes when being led by Sergeant Harker. If they're not, they don't know.
It's life skills.
It's, yeah. Crazy. Speaking about people hiding behind bushes, I've got Sly Marbo. he's a lone operative, so he's a bit like Lictor, but better. Or at least, hopefully. Like the Lictor, he's got precision. But he's also got anti-infantry 2-up and he hits on 2s. So he's very, very, very good at killing infantry characters. And he can move, shoot, move, and do fun things. And I can even order him, which is interesting. He's a one-man army. I've got 6 Borgrin. They've got the 4+ invulnerable save shields because they're just better than the other ones. So 6 Borgrins with the clubs. They love going club in. We'll see them later. I've got 3 Ogrins with the Ripper guns and the Uge knives. Although I don't think they're Uge knives for them. I think they're only Uge knives for the bodyguards. But Ripper guns, they're like heavy bolters, but better. So they're going to go in a Chimera, which has got fire in deck. So I'm going to have a Chimera with many, many guns. And then if you kill the Chimera, then some Ogrins come out very angry. so that's them. I've got some Scions, and they're going to go in a Torx Prime with a Primera Psyker and a Commissar. Why Commissar? Because I had 30 points left over. Basically, Scions can reroll hits and things when shooting something on an objective. Otherwise, they just reroll hit rolls of 1. And then if they jump out of a Torx Prime and they shoot at the same thing that the Torx Prime shot at, then they can also reroll all their wounds as well. So the idea is a Primera Psyker with full rerolls to hit and wound with a supercharged psychic attack doing much, much damage. And then afterwards, his head might explode, but I don't care by that point, really. So, yeah, Torox Prime will have the Stormbolt autocannons and the crack missiles, because I love a bit of crack. Over here, I have 2 individual Scout Sentinels to run around and point at things, do some recon, and get in the way, move block monsters, things like that, be annoying. And they can scout move, which is very nice. And then at the back, I thought I'd better bring some gun, at least in a guard list, otherwise it would be a bit odd. So I brought a Basilisk for some indirect fire, and it's really good at slowing down infantry, so that could be fun, because you're very, very quick.
Yes.
So slowing you down would be helpful. So let's do that. And then I've got a Vanquisher, because I'm beginning to really like Vanquishers. They're only 145 points now. And you get a Lehman Rush chassis with all usual guns on it. So I've got Heavy Bolters, Laz Cannon, Hunter Killer. And basically for free, you get a one-shot gun that does D6 plus 6 damage. I think strength 18 and AP 4 or something ridiculous. And it's heavy. So if I sit still and take aim, I'm hitting on 2s. And I can make it reroll 1s with a sentinel pointing at something.
Good.
And it rerolls wounds against monsters. So it's only one shot, but it is quite a reliable shot, unless I'm shooting something with an invulnerable save. Do Trinifexes have an invulnerable save?
No, but...
Oh, good.
One turn, I can turn the damage to 0.
Yes, once per game you make an attack damage 0. Okay, well, I'll make you waste that against a las gun or something, and then I'll shoot the vanquish cannon at you. but yes, D6 plus that 6 damage shot. I think if I wounded you with one of those, making that damage 0 would probably be the right move. But yeah. Anyway, that's the guard. Now we just need a roll for deployment and do the roll that doesn't really matter. Do you want to get a dice? And we can do the roll that doesn't really matter after you, sir. It's a 6. That's nice. That's not a 6. Do you want to defend or attack? Basically, do you want to pick your deployment zone and deploy first or not?
I will deploy on the opposite side of the table.
Okay, so the Tyranids are going to go over there. The Guard are going to go down here, which is perfect because then I get a better camera angle. We'll deploy, we'll alternate, and we'll be back. Right, we're back after deployment. The Guard have gone down here. I've done my redeployment with Lord Solar thing. Because originally Marbo was in the middle. He's hopped back down here because if he's in the middle of the board and I lose that roll-off, some Ron Leapers are probably going to jump for a murder him. so he's decided to pop up somewhere else. The Guard's deployment, I've put a Scout Sentinel on the flank with a Chimera full of Ogrins and the Vanquisher. The Vanquisher's down here, basically, because your Rupture Cannon's over there. If I'm over here with my 2 tanks and the other tank's behind a wall, your Rupture Cannon's going to, what, shoot a Sentinel? Fine. so that's what I've got on this flank, a bit of a mechanised push here. Strachan with his big blob with Nork Deadog is also there. So I've got quite a bit going towards that objective. Scout Sentinel fairly central to scout forwards and do things. Lord Solar's blob here with a Basilisk and the Borgrins. That's going to mob the centre. And then Sergeant Harker's got his work cut out for him. Him and his unit, I've got to take that objective all by themselves. but yeah, they're hiding in the bushes. And they will get a scout move in a minute. And off the board for me, I've got the Scions with the Psyker and the Combisar in the Torox Prime to come on somewhere, nuke something, and then die very quickly. So that's the Guards deployment. The Tyranids deployment, Dan, do you want to go through what's down?
So as you're looking, going from right to left, we've got some GCs with the Broodlord in the back.
Yes.
We've got some infiltrating Von Ryan's Leapers a little bit further up, just turning out from behind the obscuring tank.
Yes.
The Norn Emissary is poised and ready to take this objective on the flank as his declared objective for his rule. So he's going to get on there, get his Feel No Pain, and become OC-15. Provided he doesn't die first.
It's all right. Sergeant Harker, I have faith in him and his 10 Catachans. They will be able to take that objective from the Ron Leapers and the Norn Emissary with ease.
Good.
I'm not entirely sure it will go that way, but we'll find out.
The Tyrannofax lumbered onto the battlefield quite late and has clearly left himself a little bit out of position. The next unit of Von Ryan's Leapers holding my backfield objective, and then a pair of Maliceptors over on the far flank, ready to trundle forwards, and that leaves Things with Wings and Mort Burrows in reserve.
In Deep Strike, yeah. Oh, and obviously you've got your Lictor there as well.
Lictor too.
Because obviously he can rapid ingress for free if you want him to. Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't infiltrate him, to be fair, because he can infiltrate in lone operative and things. But I guess with this one, if you infiltrate, it's no man's land, and I can probably quite easily get within range to shoot him anyway. So, yeah. Okay, cool. It's just a matter for rolling off now, isn't it? And then we can do our scout moves and things. So after you, sir, good luck. It's a 5. So you've rolled a 6 and a 5 so far. You're rolling well today.
It's only going to get worse.
Well, it seems to be. Ooh, it's a 5. Okay, so you're going to roll a 4 now. There we go, see? Well, you still go first, though, but your next roll will be a 3. Anyway, we'll do our scout moves, and then we'll be back for Tyranids turn 1. Okay, Tyranids turn 1, command movement phase. We've got CPs and things, and you've got capture enemy outposts and deploy teleport homer.
Yeah, so there's a keenness to get into, but perhaps a little over keen and overzealous or with the capturing enemy outpost, given what it's currently sat on it.
Yes, I've got the best part of like 50 OCs as a command.
So it seemed optimistic.
Just a bit, yes.
So what we thought we would do is actually just do deploy teleport homers. So the Von Ryan's Leapers have shunted across to do that.
Yeah.
The Norn Emissary is trundling forwards towards his preferred objective, and then with all the shuffling and redeployment shenanigans, there was movement away from me on the
my
left flank.
Everything that I could scout, I scouted backwards.
Yes, which left the brain bugs with a bit of a quandary. So they have tucked in behind the obscuring wreckage.
Yes,
and they are shunting their way across into the midfield.
Yes, the brain bugs were confused for a moment. yeah, so one of them's completely hidden. I can see the other one, but they're hiding as best they can because there was no way you can get in range. The other Sentinel scouted backwards, and these scouted backwards as well. Because, if they stayed where they were, they would get eaten.
Yeah.
And then your Genesee has obviously moved forwards, and your Rupture Cannon T-Fex moved forwards a bit, and I think his only target is literally either a Borgrin through a window or some Catchens.
Yeah, which we thought probably the Borgrin were the preferred target.
For a Rupture Cannon?
Yeah.
Yeah. yeah. So I guess in terms of shooting phase, I guess we better start with the Rupture Cannon?
Yeah, so we've got the one of the attacks we can do with the Norn Emissary as well, but we'll start with the Rupture Cannon because, like I said, it's only really got one target which we want to put it into.
Yeah, so it's 2 shots. It's heavy, but you move, so you hit on freeze normally, yes. Right? Into the Borgrin. Okay. You've hit twice.
So they've hit, and I'm guessing
on toughness 6. I'm assuming you're only on 2s.
Yeah, so you're on 2s.
Yes.
So they've got it.
It's all right. They got 4 plus invulnerable saves. They've got very big shields. Mm. They're not helping. I'm actually going to CP one of those. I don't want them both dying. Yay! So just one goes through. 2d6 damage, but they reduce damage by 1, which becomes 3.
Okay.
Unless you want to CP that, because they do have a Feel No Pain as well. 6 up, and they have 3 wounds each. So you might not even kill one.
Yeah, no,
we will. You're going to CP it. No, it's 2 damage. you're definitely not going to kill one. you've took 2 wounds off a Borgrin with a Rupture Cannon.
That is not the best opening salvo.
No, I mean, I guess some of it probably hit the ruin, right?
That's what we'll go with.
Yeah, Norn Emissary. Then he's got some shooting attacks.
Yeah, so he's got several different attacks he could do. So they, do you say they are toughness six?
Toughness six with a 4+ invulnerable save, 3 wounds, minus 1 damage, and a 6 up for no pain. Okay. They're quite tough. Okay. Yes.
Well, if we do the kind of anti infantry attack, so it's 2d6 attacks.
Okay. Is it got blast as well?
It does. Yeah.
Okay, so we'll get an extra one so to that.
Six then. And seven.
Seven. And what's he hit on?
He'll be hit on twos.
Oh, nice. Okay. So you still missed twice. Brilliant. What's the strength for this?
There's six.
So fours. Four. Just the two.
Couple there. Minus one.
Yeah. It's always a 4+ in one level save for these Borgrins, basically. So they both go through. What's the damage?
Single damage each, which you can't reduce.
I can't reduce damage 1 to 0, unfortunately, but I do get through no pains. So you still might not kill him. You've killed him and wounded another one. How dare you? It's not very nice.
Now there's blood in the water.
Yeah. So that's, is that all you're shooting?
That is everything.
That was good. That was a good shooting phase. But you have deployed Teleport Omen for 3 points.
Yep.
So there's some points at least. And what are you going to do with Capture Enemy Outpost? Ditch it for a CP?
I'm going to ditch it.
Yeah, I thought you might. All right. And then we'll come back for the guards, turn one. Right, it's guard turn one. Command phase, got 2 CP because Lord Solar, so that's lovely. Tyranids are back up to 1 CP. 3 points in the lead of Tyranids, which is very nice. But I've got extended my battle lines and no prisoners. So I need to hold my home objective, not a problem, and take one in no man's land, fine. And no prisoners. Kill bugs. It's quite simple. And there's been orders and things. So essentially, every unit with a 1 next to it has been told to take cover. So the 2 infantry blobs. Slime Marbo and this sentinel over here got told to move by Colonel Strachan. Sergeant Harker has told his unit to take aim. He's seen some gene sealers through the bushes, so he wants to shoot them. The Borgrins also got told to move by Lord Solar, so they're busting through and they've got like a 2 or 3 inch charge into some Rond Leapers. But if I kill all of them with guns, then I could charge them on emissary with Borgrins. They've got 4+ invulnerable saves, they might be able to tank it. This big unit staying still. The Basilisk got told to take aim, and so that hitting on 2s rolling 1s is definitely going to be a thing with heavy and improving Blizzard skill and things. And the Vanquisher got told to take aim as well. So he's going to be hitting on 2s and rolling 1s. So the Chimera with the Ogryns has gone to here. It is in range of the Maliceptors with the Ripper guns inside as well, so that's nice. These guys shuffled here, and that was about it, really. So starting the shooting phase, this Sentinel's going to point at that Mana Scepter, so I can reroll hit rolls of 1 against it, and ignore indirect fire penalties against that one, but Basilisk not shooting that way anyway. And this Sentinel's doing the exact same thing for the Rond Leapers, so the Basilisk can shoot and annihilate as many Rond Leapers as possible before the Borgrins go in, because they've got fight first, and they could kill the Borgrin, potentially. Maybe. But I will start the shooting phase with... Let's start with the Basilisk, actually. Let's start with that. Mm-hmm. So it's D6 plus 3 shots, plus an extra 1 for blast. D6 plus 4. For 7 shots. How many Rond Leapers are there?
6.
Oh, that's perfect. It's enough.
Continue.
Hitting on 2s, because of take aim heavy and ignoring indirect fire penalties, and rerolling 1s and 6 will be lethal because he stayed still. So I've hit every time, that auto wounds, and their toughness 5? So winning on 3s, strength 8. I've dropped 1, but still 6, it's enough. But I think they've got 3 wounds each, haven't they, or something? Oh, I'm going to damage 2. it is AP2 though. But so you will be getting cover.
Or 6. Oh, so no, so 5's with the cover.
Yeah. So every 2 will kill a Rond Leaper, basically. So I've killed 2 and put 1 down to a wound.
There you go.
Okay, that's not bad. I'll take that for something that's hiding behind a ruin. Guard shooting, isn't it great? Right, staying on this side then, let's put everything from Harker's unit into those gene sealers. And I'm going to supercharge his heavy bolter. That's hilarious. Yes, moving on to the Harker and his merry men shooting the geniuses. You spent your CP on rapid regeneration for no pain. Lovely. Harker's going to do his once per game payback thing. So his heavy bolter has now got 6 shots and sustained hits 3.
Okay.
And he's taking aim, so he's hit on 2s. I've rolled some sixes. I've rolled three sixes.
Hmm.
That's nine extra hits.
Good.
And I've hit every time. Oh dear. Luckily he moves, so they're not lethal. But I've hit you that many times with one heavy bolter. Right, I've never hit this many times with one heavy bolter before. It's insane. Strength 5, genius toughness 4, aren't they? So, freeze to wound. Oh, that came around, though, didn't it? That wasn't the best. But still, I've still wounded you many times when I only had 6 shots. That's 7 wounds at AP 1. But they've got 5 up in vulnerable save, haven't they? So, 7 5 ups.
5 ups.
You make up save. And
6.
And so you've got 6 lots of 2 feel no pains, 2 at a time, basically. So, first 2, he's dead. Next 1, he's dead. Next 1, he's got a wound left. And then another 2 on him.
He's dead.
And then, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, 2 damage a time. And that's another 1. And then there was 1 more that went through for another 2 damage. Okay, so I've killed 4 and wounded 1.
Mm.
Yeah. That wasn't bad, was it? For one heavy bolter. You've got a gene sealer left on a wound.
Yeah.
It's nice.
No, it's not.
Flashlights, hit on freeze to take aim. And oh my god, they did not take aim, did they? They're wounding on 5s. There's 2 wounds though. 2 invulnerable saves on your gene sealer. And then you got a feel no pain on a guy on a wound. Oh, he's still on a wound. He lives. Okay, so you've got 1 genius left and a broodlord. I don't know if I prefer that or not, because now they've got to take a battle shot test. Because if I killed the genius stealer, you wouldn't have to. But you're in sign-ups range from the big guy, right?
Yeah.
That wasn't bad, though, was it? Getting 15 hits with a heavy bolter. That was lovely. That was a bit OP. Right, moving on. Let's do some fun things over here. Let's shoot everything from the Vanquisher tank into the mana scepter it can see. I'll start with the Vanquisher cannon. It's hitting on 2s, rerolling on 1s because of Sentinel, take aim and heavy. Oh, look, it's hit. What's tougher than mana scepter? Is that what you're checking?
11, I believe.
Okay, well, unless it's 9 and winning on 3s. It's a wound.
Okay.
That is AP a billion, but you have an invulnerable save, right?
You have a 4 plus invul.
Okay. Oh dear. It's D6 plus 6 damage.
Mm.
That's 10 damage.
He's still with us.
How many wounds has he got left?
Just 4.
Okay. But I'm not shot his other guns yet, so hold on. Last cannon. On 3s, rerolling 1s because of take aim and sentinel. That's a 1 reroll. Oh, he still misses. Hunter killer on 3s. That hits. And that wounds. Another invulnerable save from the hunter killer. Oh dear. D6 for 1? How many wounds do you have left?
4.
So that'll put him on 3 wounds, right? I've got 2 CP, you see? No, that's fine. You can have the 1 extra damage, that's fine. And then I've got 2 heavy bolters on the side, which will hit on 3s and reroll 1s. And they're lethal because I stayed still and sustained. It's all about heavy bolters, the guard. Toughness 10, though, right, Mana Scepter?
11.
11, so 6s to win with these. Oh, okay. that's 6. There's definitely ruins and things in the way, so no AP, essentially. So 6 normal saves.
Hunter 3.
And 2 damage apiece. So he's down to 1 wound remaining. That was pretty good shooting, Mr. Vanquisher. Okay, you've got a couple of targets left on a wound. Mm-hmm. And I've got some flashlights sitting around. This unit's got many flashlights. Unfortunately, none of the flamers and the heavy flamers or the plasma are all in line of sight or range, so it's literally just flashlights. 7 are going to try and finish off that Maliceptor, and 8 are going to try and finish off that Ron Leaper. So I've got 7 into the Maliceptor on 4s, rerolling 1s because of the Sentinel. Let's not forget that. It might make the difference. It got me 1 extra hit. Definitely wounding on 6s.
Yes.
There's 2. Is it going to be death by flashlights for the Maliceptor? No, not quite. Right. I'd worry for a moment there. 8 flashlights into the Ron Leaper then on 4s and rerolling once, but didn't get any. Annoyingly, I moved the units, so I'm not getting any lethal hits. There's 3s, they missed. winning on 5s. 3 on the Ron Leapers. What's their normal save? 5s? 4s?
Normally 4 ups.
Yeah. So I've killed the guy on a wound and wounded another one. That's going to help the Borgrins out a bit. Mm. That's good. Okay, so he's dead. And then I've got my Chimera and things and the mighty Marbo. Okay, moving on to the Chimera. I've got Ogryns in here with ripper guns, and they're essentially heavy bolters. But at half range, they get an extra 3 shots. They're like double heavy bolters at rapid fire range. And I've got a heavy bolt on the Chimera. So they're all going to go into that mana sector, as is the multi-laser and all the flashlights. And then the Hunter Killer is going to go into the one that's not been wounded yet. Alright, so essentially I've got 9 heavy bolter type shots. So let's start with those, hitting on 4s and rerolling 1s. Luckily I didn't get any 6s because the Chimera one would have had sustained. So I probably should have done them separately. But I think I'm only 6s, so it all worked out fine. Wounding on, you said you were toughness 10 or 11? 6s. There's 2 at AP1. And you're not going to get cover from a barricade, you're not infantry. So 4s. He's taken 4 more damage. He's dead. Yes. Does he go boom boom? Or splat? Or whatever it is for Tyranids. cool. And then the Hunter Killer is going to go into the other one on a 4. And it misses. Brilliant. Okay. Right, one big bug down. That's going to help no prisoners. Sly Marbo, he's going to try and take up one all by himself. He's going to throw some grenades for a CP. 4 up some mortal wounds. There is 4 mortal wounds on your man sector. Boom! You know, Sly Marbo once threw a grenade at some gene stealers. 10 of them died, and then it blew up. he's now going to shoot you with his little pistol. I need to check the stats on it. Right, ripper pistol, hitting on 2s, because, you know, he's Marbo. He's hit every time. It's anti-infantry 2 up, but you're a monster. So 6s, it's only strength 5. But there's 1, AP1, but you're behind the Bane Blade, so it'll be a 3 up. Oh, you're fine. But now he can move, and he's got a move characteristic of 9 at the moment. Hooray. Right, into the charge phase then. Marbo has ran into the bushes. Just essentially screen you out from deep striking. I could have run backwards to keep him safe, but he likes going into bushes. Have you seen the movie? Borgrin charging the Ron Leapers. Need a 4-inch charge. They've made the charge. Right, the Borgrins have gone in, but of course Ron Leapers have fight first, which is why I shot them a bit first. So you've got many attacks hitting on 3s.
So 3s.
That's many hits. You've only dropped a few. That was good. That was good. But you're winning on 5s. Because tough old ball wounds. And 3.
3 minus 1.
It's invulnerable saves. I've got on 2 wounds. He takes 2, but he does have a feel no pain. I do also have a CP. No, I'm not going to CP it. I'm going to feel no pain it. Damn it! No, he's dead. So, 1 dead Borgrin, but hopefully in a minute, many dead Ron Leapers. Alright, the Borgrin's clubbing you back on their night out. Hitting on 3s. See, when you hit on 3s, you hit nearly all the times. When I hit on 3s, didn't work out like that.
So you've made saves, so it's give and take.
Well, I mean, it's guard combat, right? winning on 3s, though, strength 7. Oh dear. It's only 4. It's only 4 at AP1.
Four 5 ups.
And 2 damage each. So I've killed a Ron Leaper.
You have.
Oh no, one was wounded, so I kill him.
One and then put the next one onto 1 wound.
Yeah. Okay. I was hoping to kill the unit and no prisoners and things, but fine. Would have been nice to kill that last gene stealer as well. But never mind, I've only killed a unit, but it was a good one to kill, I guess. And I've extended my battle lines, so I'll get 7 points as we'll go into Tyranids turn 2. Right, Tyranids turn 2, commander movement phase. You passed your battle shot with your Ron Leapers and you insane braved your gene stealers to guarantee you getting the 5 primary points there, so you get your 10. You've still got a CP left, and you've got engage on all fronts and bring it down. So basically spread out everywhere and kill vehicles.
Yep.
So yeah, nice and simple. Do you want to walk through what you've done?
So coming from this, we have dropped some rippers into this table quarter.
Yes.
We've got the Broodlord, who has moved up with his single gene stealer in tow. The Norn emissary has moved onto his objective. The Von Ryans have fallen back because they didn't think they could handle taking a battering too frequently this game.
Yes.
The Tyrannophex has stayed still and has a line of sight on a couple of potential targets, whilst the Maliceptor has moved over from where he was, trying to stay away from that Vanquisher cannon.
Yes, it's pretty painful, isn't it, when it does stuff?
I don't want to see that again quite so soon.
Yes.
And then our kind of flying contingent has dropped in from the sky. So we've got the 10 gargoyles with the Prime and the
Hive Tyrant
in behind her.
Yeah. Cool. And then Marbo was about to overwatch because he can move, shoot, move. And it's not just in the shooting phase where he can do it. It's just every time he shoots. Mm-hmm. So that's nice. So he gets to overwatch and then run away. And his move characteristic is still 9, mm-hmm. which is great. So he's just going to shoot your gargoyles on 6s. I've missed every time. Fine. But now he can move. So basically I've spent a CP to move a model.
Yeah.
I'll take that. Right, yes, Marbo did absolutely nothing except for scare the gargoyles and run over there. I've run as far away as I can. A few reasons why he's run over here. One, he's still just about in order range. If I get behind enemy lines and deploy teleport home the next time, I'm absolutely laughing. And it means he can only get shot at by one gun, because lone operative is a thing. So that's why he's run over there. So yeah, Tyranid's shooting phase. Off we go. Where are we starting?
So we're going to start with the gargoyles.
Okay.
And we worked out when we dropped them in that 7 of them were in range to shoot the sentinel.
Okay.
And with the prime, so although they've only got strength 5 guns, and he's toughness 7, they have lethal hits against vehicles.
Yes.
And they get sustained from the prime.
Yes. But I'm assuming they're hitting on 4s, right?
They are hitting on 4s, yeah.
Yeah. Did you want to shoot the one that's in range of Marbo at Marbo? Because I'm pretty sure that one's probably one of the ones that's not in range of the Sentinel.
Yeah, we'll shoot him as well in MO.
Okay, all right. So you've got 7 shots into the Sentinel on 4s. 6s do things. So you've missed a few times, many times. That one auto wounds, and then you put another one back in because it's sustained. So it's 2 wounds. Nice. Any AP on Flesh Borers these days?
Nothing at all.
Oh, they used to be AP 1 in 9th. They were hilarious. Because you could get them up to AP 2 with Kronos. I take a wound. Down to 6. Lovely. That was good shooting text. And the one into Marbo?
The one into Marbo.
I think he's stealth. But that's lethal and it explodes. So you just one room roll. Oh no, because he's not a vehicle.
Not a vehicle.
Yeah. So, but it's still 2 wounds. I'm through bushes, so I get cover. 4 up saves. Oh, he takes a wound! Oh. Wounded Marbo with a flesh borer. It's alright. If it bleeds, you can kill it. Yep, 3 wounds left on Marbo, and now we've got the heavy venom cannon from the Hive Tyrant lining up the Sentinel, which would be D3 shots these days, which is a bit poo, but D3 shots.
So D3.
For the one. You do have a CP.
Yeah. I'm not using it.
You're not using it?
No.
Okay, so you're going to hit on a 2. You've hit, and you're going to wound on a 3. And you've got a reroll of thingy with his enhancement. Yeah, you did something. AP?
AP is -2.
Okay,
I'm looking at entirely the wrong profile.
I'm pretty sure it's AP 2, though. I roll the dice. Assuming it's more than AP 1, you've damaged me. And it's flat 3 damage? I think they're flat 3 damage.
My app has had a stroke.
It's all right, we'll figure it out. Right, moving over to the Tyrannophex. He's got a big rupture cannon. Is he going to shoot a Borgon in the face again?
No.
No, he's going to shoot a Sentinel because he's got to bring it down.
He's going to try.
You're hitting on 2s because of heavy, and 6 is lethal. You've hit both the times. Tough on 7, so I'm pretty sure you're winning on 2s. And it's AP.
-4.
I won't be getting a save. That's 4d6 damage. Oh, look, it's a very dead Sentinel. Does it go boom boom? Yes! Oh no. Right, we're moving across to the Norn emissary. He's going to try and melt some Borgrins with your melter profile. So 2 shots hitting on 2s. You've hit both the times. It's wounding on twos. It's 12, you said.
Yep.
And you've wounded once.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a 4+ invulnerable save. I've made my 4+ invulnerable save.
Right, in that case, we are putting in the...
the Maliceptor. Brain power.
D6 plus 3. Sorry. Yeah, D6 plus 3.
There's no blast. Eight shots. This will do it. Volume is what you need to kill Borgrins, because they've only got 4 up save, so it's just volume. Hitting on threes?
Hitting on threes.
Everything's hit. Doesn't have lethal or sustained or anything,
does it?
No. What's the strength for this?
These are strength 10.
Okay, so threes. That's what we make them all 3 ups again. Oh my god, wasn't far off. Does it have devastating?
It does not.
No. Oh, thank god for that. So what's that? 7?
7 at minus 2 is probably invulnerable.
4+ invulnerable saves. I've made 1. If it was a 3 up invulnerable save, I'd be laughing. What's the damage of this thing?
They're 3 getting reduced to 2.
So 2 damage each. Right. Okay. Right, so I'll take the first one. Feel no pains. I had a guy who was wounded, didn't I? Oh no, he died. Okay, so someone's down to a wound. Next one. Now he's dead. Right, so you've killed that guy. And then the next 2 lots of feel no pains kills another guy. And then the next 4 feel no pains kills another guy. So you've killed 3, and I had 4. Oh, that's nice. I've got 1 left. Right, look at some potential charges. You're thinking about charging a T-Fex into the Borgrin because you want these guys to sit on the objectives. So yes. It's a very long charge for the T-Fex.
Yes, yeah, so it's a 9, and this is definitely not being re-rolled. But if it makes it in, we'll all be very happy.
No. It's an 8. It's so close. Are you sure you don't want to re-roll it?
Definitely not.
Are you going to charge anything else in then?
No, they're going to sit there, and the gargoyles have surged forward after they shot, so they are now sitting on... the objective on that left side as well.
Yes, and they can't charge because they moved.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, okay. So that's good. So then, at the end of your turn, because Genesis are well out of charge range. Mm-hmm. I mean, you could charge really Ripper Swarm 9 inches, but then if it dies, then you're not getting engaged for that quarter. So, yeah. But you have got 3 for engage and 3 points for bring it down because you killed Burt Sentinel. Very nice. Okay, it's guard turn 2. I've done the commander movement phase. So I've got my CPs, got my orders. Not orders, secondaries. Find enemy lines and assassinate. It's perfect. Marbo's right over there. He can do both by himself. It'd be amazing. He's a one-man army. And then I did my orders and things. And then you battle shot me with Shadow in the Warp. And most of my orders then went bye-bye.
Yes.
Because guard leadership is terrible. so essentially... the only things that passed the battle shot were the 2 blobs and Slime Arbo. I think pretty much everything else then failed. So objective control's a thing. Borgrins ran over there. Harker and his men have moved forwards because I want to shoot and finish off the Genesir and the Broodlord and then charge Rubber Swarm and kill that. He got ordered to take aim, but he's battle shot, so the order goes bye bye. Bazesk and these guys are sitting here. Vanquisher moved slightly, staying away from that rupture cannon, but at least he can see the Hive Tyrant now. And because I had no OC between these two, I got the Ogryns out, because at least they're not battle shot. And then I can murder all these gargoyles and then hold that objective. That'd be lovely. Marbo stayed still, because Overwatch is a thing, and he's in range of the gargoyles anyway, and he's got precision, so he can just shoot the prime. It'd be lovely. It's fine. Because you don't need to be in range of the character. Just shoot the unit and then just allocate the wounds. It's fantastic. These guys, though, that weren't battle shot, were told to move, move, move. Because I want Strachan and Nought Dead Old to go and kill a big monster all by themselves. That'd be fantastic. And these guys were told to move, move, move. But because Mazis got battle shot and has no OC, they're holding there instead. There'll be my second wave of cannon fodder guardsmen going in. Scions are going to wait a turn. And you rapid ingressed Lictor, who isn't Victor, because that's what my Lictor's called, over there, out of 12 inches, so I can't shoot him.
Yes.
Or her. It.
Them.
Them. They. I don't know. You need to name your Lictor. I've got Victor and his sister as my 2 Lictors.
Okay.
Yeah. right, so, interesting command movement phase. I did get 5 on the primary, So I'm now up to 12 points to the Tyranids 19. Mm-hmm. But I should be able to get assassinated behind enemy lines because Marbo will score all the points himself. Yeah. All right. Because of that, I'm going to start with Sly Marbo.
Okay.
Just to show everyone he can do it all himself. So Ripper Pistol into the Gargoyles. He's going to hit on twos. Oh, the Sentinel will actually spot that unit as well. So we can re-roll hit rolls of one. So hitting on twos, re-rolling one. Sixes will be lethal as well because he stayed still. Mm-hmm. Luckily, I spotted them because I rolled two ones. But it's all right. I can re-roll them. And I've still got a one. Damn it. But it's anti-infantry two up. Like that. And it's AP one. But there are trees and things in the way. And I'm going to put both of them on your prime. So two normal saves on your prime. Two damage each.
Two
full
ups.
Oh!
Yes!
How many moons did he have?
He did have and still has six.
Oh, so I would have needed all three shots to go through. Okay. Fine. Well, now he's going to move because he can. At least because it's moving in my shooting phase. You can't overwatch me. So he's now definitely behind enemy lines now. right, okay, fine. At least he's getting me around enemy lines. Let's start shooting some gargoyles and things. Let's start with a heavy flamer from the Sentinel for four auto hits. And it'll win them on freeze. Like that. Four AP one on you gargoyles.
Have a save.
I guess that's four dead gargoyles then. Toast. Right, Chimera, effing into the gargoyle unit. Starting with flashlights, hitting on fours. Rerolling ones because of Sentinel. That helped a little bit. I still missed many times. They're definitely three, aren't they?
Three.
Fours to wound. There's two. Two six-up saves, apparently. One dead gargoyle.
Oh.
And then I've got C'est Moti Laser, which hits three times. And strength six, so it went on twos. That is two more, six up saves. And that's two more dead. And then I've got the heavy bolter, which goes bang, 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 and hits twice because that one explodes. And then it went on freeze. And that's just two more dead gargoyles because AP one.
That's five more dead.
Cool, lovely. Right, there's only two gargoyles on the prime left, so let's shoot loads of ogrins at move ripper guns at rapid fire range. Six shots per ogrin. Hitting on fours. Rerolling ones because of Sentinel. I've rolled many ones. That's a two. So let's reroll these. Ogrins would take aim on them. They're pretty filthy when they get in rapid fire range. That's many hits. I'm winning on three, so it's rank five. That's pretty good. AP one. So that's just two gargoyles dead.
Mm-hmm.
And then that's seven AP one on your prime.
Okay, so seven five ups.
Two damage each. 2, 4, 6. He's dead.
Yay!
For
assassination.
Yes. So Marbo didn't do it, but the old grins did. So it's fine. Right, continuing with the shooting phase. I'm going on to this big Catachan blob here. With the command squad and Dagon and things, I'm going to put absolutely everything into the mindset that can see and is in line of sight. But first, I'm going to throw a little grenade for CP. Grenada, four ups. He takes three mortal wounds as it goes boom. So he's down to seven wounds now?
Yep.
Lovely. And then I've got many flashlight shots. All right, flashlights hitting on fours because they got told to move, not take aim. And they moved, so I'm not getting lethal hits. But a wise man once said, many shots makes light work. I mean, it doesn't really, because you've got to throw more dice, so it's, if anything, it's more work. Winning on sixes, because they're flashlights. Nothing, okay? I wasted everyone's time by filming that. But it's fine. I've got three flamers, which will hit you seven times. And win on sixes. There's a wound! Did something. Three up save. Ow. And then I've got not dead Og's ripper gun, which is different to the Ogryn's ripper gun for some reason. But he hits on freeze. And he's got sustained hits, never mind. And your toughness is 10 or more, isn't it? So sixes. No, nothing. Okay, fine. At least that means I didn't kill him so I can charge him in a minute. That's fine. I'll have a few flashlights from this lot going in as well. Okay, I shot the small arms and the ripper gun from this unit. Took a few more wounds off you. You've got two wounds left now on that Maliceptor. Perfectly softened up for Strachan to kill him all by himself. And then fingered of shooting and things. Let's put everything from this unit into the Gene Stealer unit. Or what's left of it. Right, Harker and his merry men. I've got all the flashlights into the Gene Stealers. Here we go. They're in rapid fire range. And I'm hitting on fours. But I did move. So sixes are not lethal, unfortunately. So that's still a fair amount of hits. And then I'm wounding them on fives. Because it's still on the toughness of the Gene Stealer, which is nice. Because the Broodlord has high toughness. But that's only the one wound. One 5-up save from Mr. Gene Stealer. And he's dead. Perfect. Now the heavy bolter goes bang, 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 bang from Harker and hits, just once this time.
Oh no.
And it'll wound on a 3, because the unit's toughness was 4. So that wounds. And then 1 AP 1, but he's got a 4 pinfall, hasn't
he? He does.
And he takes 2 damage. Shot his arm off. Right. Basilisk into that Broodlord. Let's finish him off. D6 plus 3 shots for 9. This could be painful. Only hitting on 4s though with the Basilisk this time, rather than 2s rolling 1s. I couldn't order him, and there's no sentinel around. So 4s, but 6 is a lethal. And there's a few 6s. That's not bad. That's lovely. And 3 of 8, so I'm winning on 3s, right? He's toughness 6 or something. So that's another one. 4 plus invulnerable saves, and we've got 4 wounds remaining, and it's 2 damage. And now he's dead.
He's dead.
Lovely. See? And it's going to be written that Harker did that all by himself. And then the Basilisk just finished him off. right, so that's them dead. And that's Assassinate as well. It's a character. Well, technically, it's 2 characters. I forgot about him. But I can only score Assassinate once. Boo. I want 10 points for Assassinate. That's my shooting phase done. So I'm going to do some charges. Right, into the charge phase. I'm starting with Strachan and Deadog. It's a 5-inch charge for that unit into the Maliceptor. To 7. They're in. Fantastic. So I'll move them in just a moment. Borgwin is pretty much in, but he's going to go straight into those 1 leapers. I know you'll hit him first, but if he doesn't go charging in an attempt to kill something, you'll kill him in a minute anyway. And then these guys are just going to go into that Ripper Swarm. And they can just about make it, I think. Alright, all the charges have gone in. I've done the pile-ins here as well, just to save me time in a minute, basically. But of course, your Ron Leapers hit my Borgrim first, because they've got to fight first. So let's see if they can finish him off.
12 attacks.
On 3s.
3s.
That's pretty good.
And they are strength 5.
Winning on 5s. Five. Come on, Borgrim. Oh, he's going to live. It's only 1 wound. 4 up and vulnerable save. He takes a wound, but he's got to feel no pain. He takes a wound, but he lives on 2 wounds. Cool. Let's just do the Borgrim quickly while we're here then. Hitting on 3s. And he hits every time. At jump 7, he's wounding on 3s. And he's wounded 3 times at AP 1.
And so 5 up safe.
2 damage each. So he kills one of the Ron Leapers and puts the other one down to a wound. Because one was already wounded. He's slowly winning that fight. All by himself.
Yes.
Right, Sergeant Harker and his merry men attacking the Ripper Swarm. Sergeant Harker's got a knife on his back and he hits one 3s. And I think he's hit once. Probably because they're really small. But he's strength 4 on the charge and your toughness 2. So 2s. And it's at AP 1 because catch hands. So that's a wound.
Yep.
How many wounds does the base have?
4.
4, okay. Right, the rest of the catch hands. On 4s, you might live. Because I've only hit you twice.
Okay.
2's to wound though, and that's 2 more wounds off of you. So your Ripper Swarm survives on a wound. That was
unexpected.
Yeah, you were thinking about just picking them up, but yeah. Apparently there's. I've killed lots of the Ripper Swarms out on the base, but there's still 1 left. That's what it is. Cool, okay, fine. Let's punch some things with Strachan and not Deadog. I'll do a big headbutt, because that's fun. Yeah, the Maliceptor has only got 2 wounds left, so I can speed things up and just hopefully kill you with the headbutt. So on a 2 to 5. Yeah, it's a 6. That's D3 plus 3 mortal wounds. I've done 6 mortal wounds with just a headbutt. And then I'd have Strachan and all the other dudes. I mean, you're very dead.
Yeah, but Strachan didn't kill him though, did he?
No. But he shouted at Nort Dogan, go on, you finish him off. I'll get the next one. He's after the Hive Tyrant. Does it blow up, though, or go splat? No. It'd probably just give him a massive concussion. I mean, he's got a very big brain, and he's got a metal head. So, yeah, okay, well, he's dead. Card can kill things in combat, but just not Ripper Swamps. I have assassinated. I am behind enemy lines, so I'll get 8 points for that. And then we'll come back for Tyranids. Turn three. Right, it's Tyranids turn three, command moving phase, and it's at this point I realise I forgot to shoot a tank. But never mind. I think I'm doing okay without it. And he was only hitting on fours, because no take aim and no heavy, and I probably would have missed, and you got 4+ invulnerable save anyway. So what we'll say is, we rolled it off camera, and it didn't do anything. No, I forgot. But anyway, in your command phase you had two objectives for 10 points, so that was fine. You passed your battle shot test there, so that was fine. And then you spent a CP on giving your Ron Leapers sustained hits against infantry, because they want to blend that lot. I spent a CP in your command phase to tell them to take cover, because I knew they were going to get absolutely smashed by something. They're in the middle of the board. And then your secondaries are assassinate and extend battle lines. So you've already extended battle lines. Assassinate, I mean, there's Elictor and Sergeant Harker over there. So I think you should be safe there. So yeah, Elictor's moved towards them. You know, when emissaries come around. Other than that, these two units basically sort of swap places, didn't they? Your Ron Leapers busted through to charge me in a minute, and your Hive Tyrant flew back there to be on the objective, and you ran through the ruin with your Ron Leapers, and I shouted Overwatch because I had another CP, and I got loads of flamers in that unit, so it might actually do something. So let's find out. 3d6 auto hit with the normal flamers.
And I should probably use the Vilnet Paint.
It's your movement phase. You can't.
Oh, no!
Ha! So that is 11 auto hits with the flamers. So 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It's alright, they're going to wind you on fives. You're tougher as five, aren't you? Mm-hmm. There's a few, though. So that's four normal armor saves.
Four ups.
So one takes up wound. Okay, this Overwatch isn't going as well as I thought it would. I've got a heavy flamer as well, though, which hit you six times. Okay, this is good. And so wound you on fours at least. And this is an AP1.
Okay.
So five AP1.
Fives.
Okay, so that's killed that one and took a wound off another one. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then I've got many flashlights, and I'll do the rest off camera because the rest will probably miss. Right, a few moments later and many dice were rolled. I've managed to kill two and put one down to a wound, so that wasn't too shabby. However, my plasma gun guy did overheat and kill himself.
That's shit.
And you made the invulnerable save against that as well, just to rub salt into the wounds. But that wasn't too bad for Overwatch. So that's the movement phase done with now, I guess. Oh, forgot to mention, Ripper Swarm popped up there. Where did one go?
Another one just hiding behind the back of the room.
In the corners, waiting to get investigate signals, basically. Yeah, cool. Okay, should we go into the Tyranid shooting phase?
Yes.
Should we do that? Because I've been doing more shooting in your turn than, well, you probably will do in your entire shooting phase.
Not potentially, yeah.
Where would you like to start?
I might need to have a little think.
Okay. Right, one more thing to mention from the movement phase was the Ripper Swarm did a desperate breakout test from the Catchans over there. So, of course, then you could shoot them with the Norn. Mm-hmm. So, yes, Norn Emissary, we're starting with that. You're doing the many shots one?
The many shots.
Okay.
2d6.
Does it have blast?
It does.
Okay, well, I've got 10 in the unit.
Okay.
So, an extra 2 to that. So, you've got 9. And you're within 12, so you can shoot me through the bushes now and not be minus one to hit. So he hits on twos, right?
He does.
Nice.
So hit on twos.
Yes. And then what's the strength of this thing?
Strength six.
So you're still winning on twos as well. Oh, my poor guy's one. You dropped a couple, though. Six. What is the AP of that one?
The AP is minus two.
Well, I'm behind bushes and in the woods and things, so six up saves. They weren't hiding behind the bushes. You've killed six of them.
Okay.
Oh, dear. Is there any more shooting going into them?
Not from here.
Okay. Right, moving across to the Hive Tyrant. He wants to shoot Strachan and his Catachans. D6 D3 shots, but it's got blast. So you're getting an extra 5 on top of the D3 for a full 8 shots with a heavy venom cannon.
So this would be 2s.
2s to hit, yeah. And you can re-roll a thing if you wanted to. So you might as well re-roll a hit roll, right? There you go. And then you're winning on 2s. And it's AP2, isn't it, you said?
That's 5.
That's 5 at AP2. But I ordered them to take cover. But they're not in cover, so I'm just getting 6 up saves. So that's 1 save. Then it's 3 damage each?
Yes.
Medic! Another 6? No. So you killed 4 with a heavy venom cannon. Mm-hmm. That's not bad. 9th edition, you had 3 shots.
Yeah.
Now to round off the shooting phase, we've got a T-Fex point blank range, shooting a Borgrin in the face. Hitting on 2s.
Looking for 1s.
I'm looking for 1s. and you're going to be wounding on 2s. Oh, anyone's got 3? CP Arrera? No?
No.
Got 4 plus invulnerable save, you might not do it.
No, sorry.
Oh, well, 2d6 damage. For 12, but it's actually only 11.
Okay.
Alright. And then I've got 6 up feel no pains. I think you've wasted your big 12 damage shot into a ball grin.
Doesn't feel like a waste.
No. Right, the charge fangs, they're almost guaranteed charges, but this one will fail if you roll a double one with your lictor. Oh, you didn't roll a double one. Okay, so he's going in there, and then, I mean, they're basically in, but yes, they're very hungry. They are tyrannids. Anything else charging?
No, I think it's just those two.
Okay. Right, okay. Ron Leapers, we'll start with them. You've got many, many attacks, and you're doing Adrenal Surge for free, because they're in range of the Hive Tyrant, so you're going to be hitting on freeze with... What, 24 attacks? And then 5s and 6s exploding? Because you gave him the imperative thing for sustains. So, freeze to hit, 5s and 6s explode. And there's quite a few 5s and 6s, actually. So that's nice. So, 6 go back in. You hit me more times than you had attacks.
Yay.
That's a thing. Their strength is 5? Oh, not quite wounding on 2s. You're wounding on 3s.
That's right.
Didn't really roll that many 2s anyway, to be fair. Mm-hmm. And these are AP...
Just minus 1.
Only minus 1.
Mm-hmm.
And I've taken cover, so that means I've got 5 up saves.
So
11. Right, 11 5 up saves because of take cover. So I've made some. Take cover helped save a few guardsmen. That's nice. And that's only 1 damage, isn't it? Medic! Medic didn't hear them. 7 fall over. Right. Lictor into Harper and his merry men. Of course, you've got precision. So many attacks hit on 2s. Because Lictor's hit on 2s. You drop one. That's good. That's a good start. you're reading on 2s. So 4 go through. So 2 of those can kill Harker. And then you'd kill 2 other guardsmen as well.
Yep.
Basically. So you've got your assassinate and killed some guardsmen. Right, moving on to Strachan and Dead Dog's unit. I'll start off with a good old headbutt. That's going to be D3 plus 3 mortal wounds. It's lethal, isn't it? It's not Dead Dog. He's awesome. There's another 6 mortal wounds. Absolutely brutal. So that's essentially just 2 dead. That's nice. Right, Strachan. He's actually going to do something now. He's going to help out Not Dead Dog, who seems to be doing all the work by himself. He's doing the heavy lifting. Strachan will hit on 2s, 6s are lethal. And then he's going to win on 3s, like that. And these are all AP 2, 2 damage. That is 6 of them. That was good work from Strachan. He didn't even need rerolls.
6 ups.
And he's finished off the unit all by himself. Okay. There you go. All we need is Strachan and Nought Dead Og, and about 24 ablative wounds around them. Right, Strachan and Not Dead Og are absolutely awesome. So that's the end of your turn. You have scored both your secondaries for the full 10 points, assassinating and extending your battle lines, because you've got one in Elmer's Land and that one back there. So very nice, 10 points for Tyranids as we move into the Guard turn 3. Okay, it's Guard turn is 3, isn't it? Turn 3, yes, Guard turn 3. Got 10 on the primary, absolutely fantastic. And then I've got Stormpass Objective and Teleport Homer. Marbo's still over there, so he's going to deploy teleport home by those bushes there. And it must have signalled someone, because the SARS have dropped in over there. So that's what he was really doing. He wasn't deploying a teleport home, he was phoning the SARS on the old walkie-talkie. So that's what's happening over there. What else is happening? Basilisk taking aim, sitting there. Two Catchans pass their battle shock, and they're going to shoot something in the face. Big unit got told to move, move, move. They've ran onto the central objective there. Strachan's unit got ordered to move, move, move. They've ran forward to potentially charge the Hive Tyrant or the T-Fex, because I want to have something on that objective and murder all these monsters, full storm hostile objective. This tank got ordered to take aim, but then I realised because tanks and things are obscuring, which is my own decision, if I move, I can't shoot in a pit. So he's just going to sit there in case I get investigated signals. Because if this all goes to plan, both of those monsters will be dead, and then you'll just have not much. The Chimera has moved here, and he's going to start scorching this objective, because I can only get 10 primary a turn anyway. 5-10, 5-10. Might as well start getting extra points for that one. The Ogryn's got told to take aim. They're going to start shooting the Hive Tyrant as well. The Sentinel has come through here to spot the Hive Tyrant after getting told to move, move, move. And as mentioned, the Sarms are here to light up the Hive Tyrant with many rerolls. So basically, I'm going to sweep across the board, killing every bug in my path. And Sergeant Harper's unit are still holding this flank. There's still two of them left. Which is amazing to me, to be honest. I thought they would have died a long time ago. But yeah, let's start the shooting phase by spotting a Hive Tyrant with the Sentinel. So that's done. I've done that. And now I'm going to shoot the Torox Prime at the Hive Tyrant. Did you want to give him a feel no pain or anything interesting?
I probably should, because there's a lot of...
There's a lot of pain. Yeah. Yes. So CP on your feel no pain. I have two auto cannon shots, which hit on freeze, but I can reroll once because Sentinel. So only one hit, and it'll wound you on a... Not that, but it's twin linked. That will wound though. AP1, although you are in cover, so it's a 2-up save. And you're fine. Okay, but I've hit you with a Torx Prime, which is the main thing. That's all I needed to do. Storm Bolter, though, on freeze. And reroll the one, Sentinel. And then sixes with the Storm Bolter. There's another wound. 2-up save. And two crack missiles, because I love the crack. On freeze, rerolling ones. And then strength 9. Toughness 9, isn't he the winged one, I think? Fours. 2 AP2, but cover, so 2 3-up saves. And he's loving life at the moment, the Hive Tyrant, but he's been spotted by the Sentinel and targeted by the Torox Prime. So now the Sentinels and the Psyker are going to have a field day. Let's start by supercharging the Psyker with a supercharged psychic attack. Yes, supercharged psychic maelstrom, D6 plus 3 shots for 8. I'll take that. I'm not going to CP roll that. That's the 5, that's the 3. Okay, he's hitting on freeze, and you're on an objective, and he's in a unit of Scion, so he can reroll every hit, which is absolutely lovely. Oh no, he still missed twice. And then he's wounding on 5s, but rerolling all wounds because Torx Prime shot you, and he got out of Torx Prime. So looking for 5s, but 6s are devastating, that's lovely. Ow! Okay, not as good as it can be, but that is 4 devastating wounds in total, but you got feel no pains.
Fives.
4 feel no pains. Takes 3 wounds. Mm-hmm. Okay, but the pain has begun. Hazardous check. He's fine. Okay. And then the Scions might as well shoot everything to him as well. So here's the Melter Gun, which misses, but I can reroll, and it hits, and then it will wound on a... Not that, but I can reroll. It will wound on a that. 4 plus invulnerable save from the Melter Gun. Damn it. Mm-hmm. And then I've got all the Laz, which will go and not do much. Hotshot Laz on freeze. Rerolling. And then on 6s. But rerolling. So just the 1 3-up save, because they'd be 2. So you're fine. And I've got I might as well supercharge the Commissar's Plasma Pistol. Misses, but I can reroll. Now it hits. Doesn't wound, but I can reroll the wound. Still doesn't wound. Hazardous check. Oh, he's took some wounds. Poor Commissar. Right, continuing the pain train, let's shoot two flashlights at that Ron Leaper who's got a wound left. Have they got stealth, the Ron Leapers?
No.
No? I've hit them once. And, oh, I'm wounded. That's a shame. Right, fine. Everything in the unit that's underneath the Hive Tyrant technically physically can't see him. There's a ceiling in the way. So they're going to shoot out the windows at the T-Fex. So I've got 3d6 auto-hitting flamer attacks for many, many flames. 15 flamer attacks, wounding on sixes. But he's got what? Two up save T-Fex?
Yes.
Three two up saves. Oh, nearly. I've got the heavy flamer though for 5 auto hits. Which will win on sixes as well. There's 2 at AP1. There you go, 2 free ups. Yay! Feel the burn. 2 wounds to the T-Fex. And then I've got the Ripper Gun from Not Dead Dog, which will hit on threes and win on sixes. And there's another one at AP1 on the T-Fex, so free up save. That's 2 damage. Mm-hmm. So that's what, 4 in total?
It's down to 12.
Down to 12. 12. And then I've got the 2 plasma pistols, which I'm not going to supercharge. I'd like my characters to live. Because the Commissar, he only has 3 wounds, he's dead. So let's shoot the plasma pistols. 1 hits. And does wound. AP2 though, didn't supercharge. That's a 4 up or 1 damage. 1 damage! 11 on the T-Fex. Right. Okay, I've got some Ripper Guns that can shoot the Hive Tyrant, so let's do that. Ogryn's shooting up at the Hive Tyrant. They're not in rapid fire range, so, well, 9 shots, 3 shots each, can't count, 3 times 3. They got told to take aim, so they hit on 3s. I'm rerolling 1s because of the Sentinel. And then, toughness 9, so 5s. Nothing. But they made lots of loud banging noises. Ogryn's would be great. They'd fit in very well with a bunch of orcs, Ogryn's. They're like orcs, but just not green. Sentinel's out of range. He can't see anything. So I've got all this lot. I'll put all of that into the Hive Tyrant. I'll do it off camera because that's a billion shots and it'll take a very long time. And then I think what I'll do is I'll actually just shoot the Basilisk at that Ron Leaper just to get rid of it, essentially. Because then you need something to sit on the objective then. So D6 plus 3 from the Basilisk for 4 shots. He's taking aim. And it's heavy, but they're stealth, we found out. So I'd be hitting on 4s. Because Sentinel didn't spot him. So 4s. 6s are lethal. Didn't get any 6s. And then 3s. 1 at AP2, but cover. So AP1. And he's dead. 2 damage. Yeah, you've finally finished off those annoying Ron Leapers. I'll do a billion shots off camera. Okay, much dice rolling later with all the flashlights and the bolt guns and the plasma guns and things. Basically, I did 2 extra wounds on your Hive Tyrant with the plasma. So he's down to 5. And the T-Fex is on 11. So what I'm going to do is this big blob here is going to charge both the units. Because I'm feeling greedy with this Catachan blob of murderousness. So let's do it. I'll probably need to CP reroll that. Because, yeah. Let's CP reroll that. That'll be enough. Let's throw them in. So the Catachans and Strachan have gone like that. Some are up there hitting the Hive Tyrant. Some are down there. Not Deadog managed to get to the T-Fex. Strachan's going for the Hive Tyrant. The Scions are going to go into the Hive Tyrant as well on a 9. That's a 10. They've made it. Maybe the Psycho can finish off with his staff. Right, the Scions have made it into the Hive Tyrant as well. They're down there. At the start of the fight phase, your Hive Tyrant can pick a unit and reduce all my attacks characteristics for models in that unit by 1. So essentially, the Jungle Fighters will still have 1, but you'll reduce the attacks coming in from the Commander, Strachan, and Deadog, which would be handy. Mm. As long as you don't roll a 1. That's not a 1, so you've done that. Okay, cool. Right. And then, Nort Deadog is going to headbutt your T-Fex. Yeah.
And just before we forget, he's going to also use Death Frenzy.
Death Frenzy on the Hive Tyrant, so yeah. Potentially fighting on death. Right. Headbutt. 5. I think that's D3. Yep. for one mortal wound. Oh, he's letting me down now. One more wound on the T-Fex. Every little helps. You're down to 10. Okay, cool. Right, let's start with Strachan then. Yeah, so Strachan and the few dudes up here will hit your Hive Tyrant. The rest of them will hit your T-Fex. But I'll start with Strachan. He's only got 5 attacks now because Hive Tyrant's big and scary or something. But he's going to hit you on 2s. 6s will be lethal. Could have rerolled, but I didn't need to. And then I'm winning on 4s because of anti-monster 4 up. And he can reroll wounds because he charged. So that is 4. 4 plus invulnerable saves. 2 damage apiece. That's 4 DiMaggios. Mm. How many wounds did he have? 5. So he's got 1 left. Okay, I've got a few guardsmen hitting him. It's fine. He's got 4 friends up there with him. So here we go. 4s, 6s are lethal. And then that won't wound. But that's AP1 because Catchan's charging. 3 up save. Will a Catchan kill a Hive Tyrant all by himself? Yes, apparently he will. It's the guy with the really big knife, though. Look, he's got a really big knife and he just shoved it somewhere rather painful. does he deadly demise? No, he just goes splat. Okay, cool.
On 4+, he will be able to...
Fight on death and things. He will fight on death in a minute. Okay, we'll do that in a moment because I've got the rest of the guys hitting the T-Fex.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, not dead dog then from this unit. He's only got 5 attacks now, but he still hits on 2s. 6s will be lethal because of Strachan, but everything's hit. No lethals. He's going to wound on 5s, but 6s are devastating with his Ooge knife. There's a devastating, and that's it. So that's 2 damage. You can either negate it or just take take 2 damage. Yeah, you'll do your once per game negating thing. Okay, so you've done that, and then there's a bunch of jungle fighters stabbing you. Right, I've got 7 jungle fighters there before the commander hits you, so they'll hit on 4s. 6s will be lethal. Damn it, no 6s. And then 6s to wound, but AP1. Just catch hands on the charge. No, nothing. Okay, I guess the commander's got to give you an uppercut. Right, the platoon commander's only got 2 attacks of his power fist now. Oh, he's missed. That was really worth me starting to film for that. okay, so that's one of my attacks done. I've done a couple of wounds to your T-Fex, and obviously the Hive Tyrant is dead, but he will get to fight me back with his talons and things, whatever he's got.
His Tyrant Talons.
Tyrant Talons. Okay, cool. Go for it.
So 5 attacks.
5 attacks, hitting on 2s. You've got your enhancement. You can re-roll that.
Yeah.
It's helped. You've hit. Strength for this?
Strength is 7.
So winning on 2s. Okay, and what's the AP?
It is -2.
-2. What's the damage?
2 each.
Okay, so medic! 4 guys die. Right, Winged Hive Tyrant's now fallen over. I've consolidated. Now you get to kick me with your T-Fex, basically.
So 4 double. 4 attacks, hit on 3s.
Yes, you've hit every time. And then what's your strength?
And it's strength 8.
So you're definitely winning on 2s. What's the AP?
Absolutely nothing.
Oh. What is it good for? Absolutely nothing. But fail on the saves, what's the damage?
2 each.
Feel no pains? No, 4 dead. I haven't got much left in that unit now, but it has delivered a lot of pain.
Yeah.
Right, there is 1 normal Catachan left in that, what's left of the blob, and then the command squad and things. So, yeah, okay, that's okay, I guess. And then at the end of my turn, I have definitely stormed the hostile objective because I've got the Scions there as well, because of course they made their charge, which was glorious. And I've brought a teleport armor. So that is 10 points to the guard as we're moving to Tyranids turn 4 to see what they can do. They've got 2 big monsters and Elytra and some river swarms. Hmm. Okay, Tyranids turn 4. At the end of battle round 3, I was ahead by a point, 40 to 39, but now you've obviously got your 5 primary for there. So it's 44 to Tyranids to my 40 points, so it's still very close. Your secondaries are Overwhelming Force, kill things on objectives, and Defend Your Stronghold. Not ideal, and that was after you spent a CP to swap out something? Yeah,
that was looking for something better than Secure Nomads.
Yeah, because Secure Nomads then was completely impossible. so, yeah, not ideal secondaries. If you had Investigate Signals, you would have been laughing. Weedy Ripper Swarms, but not to be. Eulictus ran over there to hold that objective, so the Norn Emissary can then come off of it and start to actually do something useful, I guess. Your Ripper Swarm has got to finish off those jungle fighters, and your T-Fex is going to stay there and do things. And your Ripper Swarm passed its leadership test.
It did.
They have leadership 8. So, well done. Yeah. Synapse is a thing. Straight into the shooting phase, I guess.
Yeah. So, you might as well start with T-Fex, because you can only shoot them, really, at the minute.
Well, you can shoot out of combat, if you wanted to.
But you can't shoot anything else.
You can shoot them.
I'll shoot the units in combat with.
You might be. I mean, no. Your base can't see around the corner, can it? Can you see the Torx Prime? You could shoot the Torx Prime with your rupture cannon.
Oh, that's about a target.
Don't want to waste a rupture cannon on some guardsmen.
Right, so he's in combat, but he's heavy.
So it's back to normal. Does he have a Stinger Salvo as well? Or is it just a big gun?
No, he does. Yeah.
You could put that into the guardsmen, probably.
So we'll start with the...
rupture cannon. Well, whatever you were shooting at, you would have missed.
Yeah,
Stinger Salvo into the guardsmen. I can't remember what they do. Right, and then Stinger Salvo into the unit you're in combat with, because it's on fours, apparently. I just want to hit. So that's only 3 hits. What's the strength for this?
It is straying 5.
Okay, so 3's to wound. So 3 wounds. AP?
Nothing.
Oh, well, they're in cover, so 4's. That's... I mean, 2 go through it. What's the damage?
It is damage 1.
Medic! You killed 2 guardsmen, so that unit is no longer a whole unit.
Mm-hmm.
Right, Norn Emissary shooting the disperse thing into this big blob again, because blast is a thing. So 2d6 plus 5 shots. Luckily it's plus 5, isn't it, really? Yeah, so that would have been really bad. So 8 shots. Oh dear, hit or twos. Very nice. And then what's the strength for this again?
This is strength 6.
Okay, so 2s. And then AP
is minus 2.
So 7. They're going to go straight through. What's the damage?
1 each.
Okay. Medic! My medics have made no feel no pains today at all.
Yeah.
Instead, 7 guardsmen die, hoping that a medic would help them. But he never came. Right, charge phase. Ripper Swarm's gone back in, so he's going to hit on 5s.
Yep.
And he's got sustained hits or something. You've hit twice, and then you're winning on 5s because guardsmen are tough for them, Ripper Swarms are strong.
I think it's 6s.
No, toughness 3, strength 2, isn't it? Okay, so 5s. No, nothing. Yes. Okay, fine. Headbutt. D3 mortal wounds. For 1 mortal wound. Oh, he's running out of steam with his old headbutt. It was doing really well earlier. And then I've got the attacks. So let's do Dead Dog. Not getting lethal hits anymore, though, because Strachan's no longer attached.
No.
And there's no extra strength for AP and things. So boo hoo. He hits on 2s. And he's missed twice. And he's going to wound on 5s, but 6s are devastating. So it's up wound at AP 1, 2 damage. He takes 2 more damage, so that's 3 that Nort Deadol's done all by himself. What's he on now? 3.
3, I think.
And then I've got the Platoon Commander, which hits once and doesn't wound. And then I've got a couple of dudes. And no, nothing. Okay, cool. So that's them done. Did you want to hit me with your powerful limbs?
Powerful limbs.
Powerful limbs.
Powerful but ungainly.
Powerful but not accurate. That's a wound though. And it's one, was it 1 damage or 2 damage? 2 damage, wasn't it? You killed a dude. Right, I also did the attacks back with the jungle fighters. Failed to kill the Ripper Swarm that's only got 1 wound. So that's a thing. So at the end of your turn, you have scored no points?
No secondaries.
So I guess if you wanted to, you can ditch some cards for a CP and then we'll go into guard turn 4. Right, it's the guard turn 4. I've got 10 on the primary. And then I also finished scorching this objective here with the Chimera. So that's good. Means I can forget about it over here and just go that way now. And then my secondaries couldn't have been any better, really. Engaging all fronts, investigate signals. I passed a battle shot with those guardsmen. They fell back. They're having that quarter. I've got this quarter with a Vanquisher, which is also investigating a signal. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's killed one big monster and it's just been sitting there chilling out for the rest of the game, so it's fine. Marbo is getting me even more points. He's now going to investigate signals over there after being behind enemy lines and deploying a teleport homer and just being an absolute boss. And then the Sentinels move around here to spot the T-Fex in a minute, essentially. These guys will come running around here. Strachan's jump down. I've got all the ones next unit means take cover. All the sixes are take aim. So take cover, take aim, take aim. There will be orders going out. And yeah, that was fairly simple movement phase, really. So let's spot your T-Fex with the Sentinel. And then let's shoot your T-Fex with... Let's start with the Scions. Let's do that, because that's fun. Oh, I can't do my psychic thing, because it's blast and you're in combat. Oh, never mind. I'll shoot the rest of the Scions at you, though. I've got a Melter gun, which, because of take aim, would be twos, but better threes, because you're in combat. That's hits. And doesn't wound. And then I've got some flashlights, which we hit on threes, rolling ones, because Scions. And then these went on sixes. That's one AP two. One damage. So okay. You're fine. And then I've got the Dolox Prime. You've only got three wounds left, haven't you? So let's leave the rest of that for combat. Although I can't see this because you're hiding behind the tank, which is obscuring. Because I said the tanks would be obscuring. So the Torox might as well just shoot everything into the T-Fex. Yeah. Got nothing else to shoot it. auto cannons, which will now hit on fours. But I can reroll ones because Sentinel spotted him. And then win on fives. Nope. Auto cannons. One hits and then doesn't wound but twin linked. Wounds, AP one. So a free up save. And you're fine. I'm not going to bother doing the Storm Bolter. I've got lots of small arms here and plasma guns and things. I'll put everything into the non-emissary. I'll do that off camera. It might take a while. Okay, yes, I shot all the guns from this blob here and the Chimera at the non-emissary. Did a few wounds. He's now on 11. 13. A couple of the plasma guys did kill themselves though, so you know, didn't all end happily. The Basilisk managed to kill two whole units all by itself. I have shaken one Ripper Swan, heavy bolt with the other one. So that was that. So into the charge phase then, it's quite simple. It's Strachan going into the back of the T-Fex. He's made it because he's literally right there. And then I'll chuck the Scions in as well, because why not? I think they've made it as well, they're just there. Cool. Right, yeah, charges moved in. I can't remember if I mentioned it or not, but the Ogryn's got in the Chimera, if anyone's wondering where they've gone. I'm going to start with Strachan. He's going to hit on twos. I don't think he's got lethal hits anymore, though, because that's only when he's leading a unit, but he still gets to reroll all his hits and wounds on the charge. So let's do that. And he's got anti-monster four up. And rerolling the wounds, because I charged. So that is many. That is five at AP two, two damage. So five, four ups. He's dead.
He's dead.
And then you paid a CP for Death Frenzy, so on a four up he fights?
Yeah.
He doesn't fight. Does he explode? No. Strachan just ripped him limb from limb. All by himself, he's now killed a Hive Tyrant and a T-Fex. He's pretty good. Right, that is the end of my turn. I've investigated signals over here and there. And I've been engaged on fronts because I'm absolutely everywhere. So we'll go into Tyranids turn 5 and see, if anything, what's possible. Right, Tyranids turn 5. It is turn 5, isn't it? Yes. You got 5 on the primary and you got cleanse. So your Lictor's going to sit there and cleanse for you for 3 points. Mm-hmm. And you still got overwhelming 4. So the non-emissary... He's coming for the blob with Lord Solar. I overwatched and took a couple of wounds off you.
Yep.
And now you're going to shoot them, so I guess.
I'm going to do the 2d6 blast.
Yes. Oh, how many have we got there now? 5, 10, 15. Yeah. So plus 3 to this now. So 10. It's more than you had last time when you had plus five. Ten attacks, hitting on twos. And he's missed a few times. He was winning on twos. Was it winning on twos?
Threes. Oh, sorry,
was
twos.
It?
Sorry, twos.
It's a
straight six.
Yeah, twos. I thought it was twos. So seven come through. And it was AP one.
Yep.
But they're taking cover, so back to five ups. So I actually made some saves. That's nice. And then it's. Was it one damage or two damage?
One or two.
I'll see if I make any sixes. I made some sixes now. We need to check the damage. The medic's finally woken up. Yeah, it's only one damage. So the medic's finally woke up and did something. So he killed a guardsman. We got the AP slightly wrong though, so I will roll another six. He killed two. Because it was AP two. There we go. I guess now it's basically charging in.
Yep.
Shame you can't tank shot the monsters, isn't it?
Yeah, no.
Unless you do crash a stampede. But you have made the charge.
Yay.
Oh, no. There's a lot for him to get through, though. Has he got a sweep attack?
He's got a couple attack profiles that he can use.
Yeah, so he must have one that has many attacks. He is quite large.
So his first one is four attacks.
Yeah, but is it like a... Oh, it's an extra attack. So he doesn't have a sweep attack, but you've got two attacks that you can do. Okay, so the extra attacks first, I guess.
This is twos.
Twos to hit. Oh dear.
He's tired.
He's been tired of sitting on that objective all game and not doing much.
Twos again.
AP?
Minus two.
Okay, so four up saves. Six up saves. Because of take cover. Both go through. Damage?
Two damage each.
Okay, medic! Okay, so two more die. I'll make a note. He's killed two. Well,
six more.
Okay.
On twos.
Oh, that's better. He's hit every time.
Twos again.
Yep. So that's five. AP?
Minus two.
Okay, so six ups again. Damage?
Three.
Three, okay. Medic! No, so he killed six in total. A big thing like that killed six. Why hasn't he got a sweep attack?
I don't know.
Right, I've piled in. Lord Solar, not Lord Solar. Here we go. He hits on twos. And there you go. He's hit more times than your normal emissary did. Strength six and your toughness?
11.
So fives. Nothing, though. Okay. And then he's got some extra hoof attacks, which do nothing. Cool. And then I've got the Ogryn Bodyguard. Right, the huge knife from the Ogryn Bodyguard. I love Ogryn Bodyguards, they're great. He'll hit on threes. That's lovely, look at that. And then he'll wound it on fives. And that's one, AP one, two damage.
On three.
And he's fine. And I won't bother with all the other dudes hitting you because they're not going to do anything. And you've got quite a lot of wounds left. What's he got left?
He has got 11 left.
11 left, okay, yeah. Cool. Okay, so at the end of your turn, you have cleansed an objective. For 3 points, and then it's guard turn five to see what's going to happen, I guess. Right, guard turn five, and I got pretty good secondaries again, I think it's fair to say. I got catch on the outpost, which is perfect, really, because my Torch Prime is literally sitting on your own objective with nothing near it. So that's done, basically. Bring it down, kill the Norn Emissary. So take aim from the Lord Solar. Spot it with the Sentinel. I've passed the Battle Shock and fell back with my dudes in the middle. And let's just quickly light him up and see if I can kill him. Because, yeah, let's start with the Vanquishar. He moves, so it's not heavy, so I'm hitting on threes, but rerolling ones because Sentinel. I've hit. It's strength many. I'm wounding on threes. It wounds. You've got an invulnerable save. You do have CPs as well. You failed. Would you like to CP that? It's many damage. Oh, no. D6 plus 6. Did you want to spend a CP for Field of Pain as well?
No.
Because everything's going into him. There's nothing else for you to spend it on.
That's true. Yeah.
So you might as well do. You would have done it. So D6 plus 6 damage. I've got loads of CP. Let's reroll this. Oh, my God. There's a 4 on the dice. Okay, so it's 11 damage.
So if I make none of these, he's dead.
Oh, has he literally got 11 wounds? Yeah. Ooh, let's see if I can one-shot him with a Vanquisher Cannon.
These are fives.
Fives. He's got 3 wounds remaining. Yeah. Okay. And then the Laz Cannon goes out. And we'll hit on a 3 to take aim. And it hits. And 3. Toughness 11, you said, didn't you? So that wounds as well. Another invulnerable save. You haven't got any CPs left. Ooh, you make it. Right. Heavy pulses. 3s, you're rolling 1s. But these will win on 6s, though. Nothing. Okay, but now what I'm going to do, because I've got an absolute buttload of CP, which I probably should have spent for reinforcements, but I don't really need it. I'll spend 2 CP now on Fields of Fire. So after he's shot you, everything else, well, any regiment or squadron unit that now shoots your thing gets an extra AP. That's lovely. Because I've told my Chimera to take aim, and it's got 2 Ogryns inside it with Ripper Guns that can shoot out the top, and they're definitely in rapid fire range. So they've got 6 shots each out the top hatch, plus the Heavy Bolter on the Chimera, and they're all the same profile, so I'll do all those shots at the same time. Right, and these are hitting on 3s because of take aim, and rerolling 1s because of Sentinel. But I did actually move the Chimera, so I'm not actually getting lethal hits. I don't know why I moved it, but I did. Probably just to park it on the objective. The actual Heavy Bolter would have had sustain. Never mind. I'll ignore the sustains because it's too complicated. 6 is to wound. And these will all be AP2 now. So 3. 3 4 ups. That's 2 damage. Feel no pains. Takes another damage. It's got 2 wounds left?
Yep.
Right, okay. Zimoti Lézard. I can reroll the 1. And then there's a win on 5s. AP1. So 1 free up. No, okay. And then I have a mini flashlights with AP. It's glorious. Can reroll the 1. Sentinel. No, okay. Really shouldn't have moved him. Look at all these 6s I'm getting. 6s to wound, Dave. 2 AP1 from flashlights. Could I kill him with flashlights? No. heavy flamer from the Sentinel. Will hit you once. Oh, I used to CP. Yeah, I did. Wounding on a 6. No. Basilisk. Shooting indirectly, even though you're right in front of me. 6 shots. And he'll be hitting on 2s, rerolling 1s because the Sentinel won't take aim. And 6s will be lethal. Didn't get any 6s. And then winning on 5s. And these are AP3 now. So AP2 because of cover. So 4 up saves, 2 damage. So that is 6 damage. We've got 2 wounds left. He's been earth-shaken to death. Just. Yes. Perfect efficiency. So I did bring him down, but it did take pretty much most of what I've got left. I love these for 140 points. They're amazing. Right, okay. So I brought it down. I've captured it on the outpost. It's just a case of summing up the points now. Right, we've looked at the points and things. The guard finished with 40 primary points, including the 5 from the scorched objective over there, and 40 secondaries with a nice capture enemy outpost and bring it down at the end. Give me 13 in one turn. Lovely. So that puts me on 90 points, and the Tyranids finish on 62, including painting. So 32 points difference, but I think the last couple of turns you just sort of ran out of assets, yeah. Really. Ran out of bugs. And I think overwatching the Ron Leapers is probably what saves my big blob, which then went running through and killing all your big monsters with headbutts. Mm. Which was absolutely brutal. But it was a good fun game. Thanks for coming down again, Dan.
No,
what do you think about Strachan and Nought Deadog? Are they ridiculously OP for guardsmen?
I don't like them.
You don't like them? What about Vanquisher Cannons? They're nice, aren't they? I
don't like them either.
No. I'm underwhelmed with the Norn Emissary. I know he was over there for most of the game getting you points. Which is why, because when you deployed him over there and your T-Fex over there, I was like, no, I'll just go over here, thank you. And sort of ignore them both, but you didn't.
Yeah. I think if you don't put him on the table with the expectation he's going to go out killing stuff, to be truthful.
Yeah.
I think, but then it's also a very big point sink.
Yeah, he's quite tough, especially when an objective with an I feel no pain.
Mm-hmm.
But he doesn't really kill much. Even with his dispersed many, many shots thing into that squad, he'd still only kill like a handful of guardsmen.
Yeah.
But yeah, interesting. Ron Leapers, though, I do like Ron Leapers. They're cool. Except for they're not very good at killing Borgrins, we found out. Yeah. But anyway, thanks for coming down. And yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. And we'll see you in the next one.